Good evening, everyone. Good evening. Welcome to our prayer call meeting. Everybody is coming in. All right, Reverend Richardson, I'm gonna let you go ahead and just greet and say hello to everybody. Your phone is on mute. You're on mute.
Good evening, everyone. I'm so excited to see you here this evening. God bless you. We are ready to praise the Lord and worship through prayer this evening. And I'm going to turn it back over to our pastor. Good evening, Pastor. We are so glad to be a part of this. I can't think of a better way to start and go into from 2022 to 2023. So God bless everyone that's here with us. And we are ready to worship through prayer with our pastor leading us this evening. God bless you.
Well, let me say good evening. I hope that everyone had a wonderful Christmas. And of course, we are certainly delighted for all of you who are joining us. And I thank God for each and every one of you who are taking time out on this New Year's Eve to be a part of this wonderful gathering. And it is something that I don't take for granted, because you all could have been doing a whole lot of other things, as well as just partying tonight. But certainly glad that you all are joining us. And my God, the people are still coming. I think we're up to 111 participants so far, and they continue to come. And so this is just absolutely wonderful. The reason that we're doing this is because with all that is going on around us, I would love to see you all in church tomorrow or connected to church tomorrow. And with New Year's Eve and with New Year's Day falling the way that it is, unfortunately, some folks will make a choice between what they're going to do. So we're certainly delighted that you all are flowing with us. And we thank God for technology that gives us the wonderful opportunity to do it this way. And so we don't take that for granted. We know that we've had 2022 has been tough for a lot of us. And as we come to this particular moment at 11:33, it has been nothing but God's grace that has brought us to this point. And it is something that I don't take for granted. And I know that the majority of us on this call don't take that for granted as well. Many of us that are on this call, we've had to go through a lot. And yet the Lord has brought us to this particular moment and at this particular time. And so we want to continue to allow for others to join us. And as you join us, real soon, what we're going to do is we're going to allow for the portals to be for you to observe names of loved ones who have made the transition in the year of 2022. We've had a lot of loss at St. Paul, and I'll talk about that a little bit later. But as we move forward with what is going on as far as where we are right now, I am just so grateful to be doing life with you all as not only your pastor, but a fellow disciple in Jesus Christ. And my God, the growth that you all have impressed upon my life has just been just absolutely incredible. And so it's something I don't take for granted. And I don't take this time that we have as far as prayer is concerned for granted. So thank you all. And I hope that you all got what your heart desired as far as Christmas is concerned. And as we sit on this precipice of getting ready to go into a new year, what a blessing. What a wonderful, incredible blessing that God is granting us as far as this opportunity is concerned. So I want to thank God for each and every one of you who is making your way as far as this time is concerned. And of course, we still have people that are joining us as far as this prayer call is concerned. So just to do a couple of housekeeping items before we get started, because I want to share with you all a devotional as far as tonight is concerned. I'm certainly glad that Reverend Richardson is able to be online. She had a procedure right before Christmas, and the Lord has allowed for her to have some sense of vim and vigor. And I can tell that even by her being on this call. And of course, others like Brother Ted Pearson, who had a procedure as well. And we want to bring them as far as the this moment is concerned. So at this particular time, as persons continue to join us, we ask for you to send in the names of persons that have made the transition during the year of 2022, from January even up until now. And I am told that we have a video that we're getting ready to share. And that video is hopefully and prayerfully it will bless us and help us to be reminded as far as our loved ones are concerned. I am certainly honored and humbled that Reverend Richardson and Minister Stevenson are giving me aid and assistance tonight. Thank you all for helping Sister Deborah as far as managing this Zoom. And I have to be honest, this is the most people that I've seen on a Zoom call that we've had as far as the church is concerned. And it's just a wonderful, wonderful sign of what we can do with technology. So that being said, as we prepare to open up and as we prepare to move forward, we thank God for each and every person, each and every portal that is open and that is shared tonight. And we're going to go ahead and get started now as far as a prayer is concerned. And I'm going to ask, since Minister Stevenson is on the line, going to ask if he would give us an opening prayer. If you would just go ahead and open up your portal, Minister Stevenson, and move us as far as this time of prayer is concerned. Jeff?
Yes.
Okay.
Let us go to God. Dear Heavenly Father God, we come before you right now. We come before you just to say thank you. Thank you, God, for this moment and for this time. God, for we know that we have come through 2022. And God, you have saw fit that everyone that is on this call to be here tonight. And for that, God, we say thank you. God, for we know that we've had some ups and downs. We've had some ebbs and flows. We've had some trying times in 2022. But by your grace and by your mercy, God, that you have sustained us to this point. And so for that, God, we just want to say thank you. We say thank you, God, for keeping us, even in the midst and in spite of everything that we've seen going on around us. We say thank you, God. And God, we thank you for the leadership that has helped guide us and navigate us through 2022. Even though we've seen so much going on, God, you provided leadership in the person of Reverend Dr. Robert Charles Scott to help guide us and navigate us through this time. And God, we say thank you for him. For we know it is not always easy, but you have given wisdom to him to help guide us. Thank you, God, for so much. For God, we can't thank you enough. But God, as we entered into this portal, God, many have come with concerns of loved ones. Many have come with concerns of heartache. Many have come, God, with things on their heart. But right now in this moment, let us all be together as one, as a family, as we celebrate and enter into this next chapter. We do it together, God. It is in your son's name that we pray and give thanks. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And thank you, Minister Stevenson. And at this time, before we have the video of the names of our loved ones who have made their transition, who have died, I want to thank Deacon Karen Archibald and Deacon Marilyn White, Brother Elson Baldwin, Minister Reverend Ben Pate and his wife, Tiffany Pate, who are helping us to navigate all of you who have joined us tonight. We have 174 portals that are open and of people that have joined us. And so we give God praise for that. And I want to thank you all for that. So at this time, Deb, I'm going to ask that if you would, let's transition to remembering those who have gone on into eternity. Thank you. Wow. Wow. Gone but not forgotten. Gone but not forgotten. Thank you for all that sent in names. And thank you, Deborah, and your team for putting together such a moving, moving remembrance as far as that's concerned. It is 8 minutes until the new year. I just want to share some thoughts with you as we move forward in the new year. And Paul has a saying in Philippians, says, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead, I press toward the mark for the calling of God that is in Christ Jesus. And I just want to talk about putting the past behind, putting the past behind. Here we are. We are 8 minutes from the threshold of a new year here in Charlotte and the surrounding area. And we're kind of excited, kind of anxious to put 2022 behind. But if we put 2022 behind, but still have the same attitude going into 2023, it doesn't matter what the change of the date is. We have the opportunity to now chart new dreams and new beginnings and passions and goals. And if the Lord allows for us to take enough breaths and have enough heartbeats and keep the blood running warm for the next 7 minutes, we will cross into a new year. But 2023 will have its own challenges and its own horizons that we have to face. And so we're not going to talk about making new year resolutions. We're not going to talk about making big changes that we need to make. What I want to press us on tonight is just be better than what we were last year. I know that some of us, we have some old unhealthy habits and some strange behaviors and got to deal with crazy people. And we think that if we cross over into the new year, that all of that's going to change. It doesn't work like that. We have to stand at this threshold with a firm intent and the concrete resolve that we're going to do something to make our 2023 better than 2022. The future is unknown, my brothers and sisters, but we know a God who knows a whole lot better about our future. The God that loves us so much that he walks with us into our future. What I want to impress upon you tonight is that so many of us are stuck in our past that we can't take hold of the wonderful things for our future because we don't want to do the things in our present to make the change. The reason why a new day is always looked forward to is because it is pregnant with the seed of possibility that gives us the impetus to keep on going on when we feel like giving up. That's what it really means to walk with God. When you and I take this journey with God, we have what the writer of Hebrews says, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Oh, how I wish that I could wash away all of your hurt, all of your pain, all of your drama, all of your trauma from 2022 and even years in the past. But I can't. But what I can do is encourage you to connect and stay connected with the God who wants to take us to another level that's going to make us a better person, a more wonderful testimony, and a more shining example of faith, hope, courage, and tenacity. I don't want you to stay stuck in 2022 and the years before. Let's go into 2023 with the wonderful possibilities that it can bring. I know 2022, there were days of laughter, but if you're honest, there were some times you shed some tears. There were times you had a smile on your face, but there were times of headache and heartache. There were times where people did some bad things to you, but there were also times where people did some good things to you. There were times when you had everything to go your way. And then there were times when nothing went your way. Don't allow for 2022 to keep you stuck. Your past mistakes, your past grudges, your past troubles, your past problems, your past drama, your past trauma, your past sufferings, your past successes, your past victories, your past relationships, your past mess. God is saying in 2023, get a life and get a life with me. Get a new beginning with me. Take me by the hand and let us usher into this new year with a sense of faith, determination, hope, courage, and tenacity to make the shifts that we need to make so that when we look back, we can say, look at what the Lord has done. And all we got to do, and it's really as simple as this, is to change our attitude and our perspective about how we view whatever happens to us, knowing that if we got God on our side, that the Lord is able to take what is negative and make it a positive. So you got to leave the past behind in order to move into your future. And if you're going to leave the past behind, you got to understand that your past and your future are sometimes on the same path, but you got to bring a different perspective to it. And you got to allow for God, here it is, to bring closure to some stuff from your past. You know what that means? Letting go of grudges, engaging in authentic forgiveness, realizing that you don't need certain folks in your life to make it, understanding that you can embrace the grief of losing a loved one and still go on. Understand that if you need to get help, that help is there. God wants to do something absolutely incredible for your life, but it's incumbent upon you to allow for God to bring closure to your past. So as I close on this evening at 11:59, before we get ready to go into prayer, you want to get beyond your past? Just do it. Go for it. Build it. Start it. Fix it. End it. Lose it. Top it. Learn it, leave it, read it, write it, save it, finance it, prioritize it, pray for it, forgive it, release it, fight it, change it, finish it. The reason why your past does not have to get you is because you got God on your side. And because you got God on your side, you too can leave the past behind and grab the glorious future that God has for you. So at this time, let us bow our heads for prayer. And I want to be the first to say to you all, Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. God, we thank you that you have ushered us from 2022 and allow for us to cross over into 2023. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. As we hear fireworks go off in the background, we have a firework of praise in our spirits. Thank you, God. And Lord, we just want to bless your name because you didn't have to let us live. You did not have to let us see this moment. And so, Lord, we don't take it for granted. And for us, particularly as Black people, Watch Night, New Year's Day, take on great significance for us because it was in 1863 when our ancestors, through the Emancipation Proclamation, were freed from slavery with the exception of the state of Texas. And so, God, we come to you with bowed heads, and we come to you with humble hearts, and we come to you with a spirit of thanksgiving, and we come to you with praise on our lips. We come to you, oh God, because we realize millions didn't make it, but we were one of the ones who did. Some of us may have come standing tall. Others may be bent over. Some of us may be crawling. And some of us may be barely holding on. But yet, God, you've allowed for us to see 2023. And for that, we give you glory. We bless your name. We honor you, oh God. And we pray right now in the name of your son, Jesus, that you will continue to remind us, oh God, of your keeping power, your sustaining power, your healing power, your delivering power. Oh God, you are absolutely incredible. And we don't want to take you for granted. So God, as we get ready to close out this prayer, help us to become better, better people, better disciples, better servants at St. Paul, better givers. For those of us that have children, let us be better parents. For those of us that have parents, let us be better children. For those of us that are married, let us be better spouses. For those of us that are single, just let us be open to whatever you have for us. For those of us that are in friendships, let us be better friends. Lord, just let us be better. And as we navigate and prepare for worship in the daylight, as we prepare for consecration service, start the preparation work of consecration even now, so that when we come into worship, that we feel something incredible, absolutely awesome, as far as the movement of your spirit in St. Paul Baptist Church at 1401 Allen Street on tomorrow. For those that may not be able to come, we pray that you will connect with us in such a way that you will move in even virtual space to be a blessing to them. And now, God, as I close out this prayer, we say thank you. Thank you, oh God, for blessing, for keeping, for empowering, for forgiving, for showing grace and mercy. We love you, oh God. And we love all of those that have joined us in this call. Bless each and every person on this call in an incredible, profound way. That they know, oh God, that the time that they have invested at this moment in prayer, in remembrance, in fellowship, and your word have not been wasted, but will strengthen them for the journey ahead. It's in the name of Jesus we pray, and in his name we claim it done. We all say hallelujah and amen. Amen. God bless you all. God bless you all. God bless you all. And thank you all. Thank you all so much. And I hope and pray that for those that can come, we will see you all on tomorrow at 10 o'clock sharp. God bless you. I love y'all. Bye-bye.
God bless. Love you.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Hi, Gloria.
Happy New Year.
All right. Happy New Year.
All right. Bye.
All right.